It is one of the most questions I get asked frequently. Can I use citric acid to lower the pH of cold-pressed soap? Spoiler alert, the short answer is no. This video is the long answer, and for this I did an experiment for you. But first, let's go deep diving into soap chemistry. By the way, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Sue. I make videos about how to make soap and the chemistry behind it. If you just enjoyed this video or maybe are also interested in the fascinating world of soap chemistry, I would appreciate it if you hit that like button and subscribe to help this channel growing and spread more of this soap making knowledge. You might have seen my video on why you should use citric acid at all for soap making. If not, you should definitely go and watch it. You'll learn something really valuable to increase your soap quality. And I also give you a little spoiler here. By reacting with the sodium hydroxide, it creates sodium citrate, which then binds the minerals in tap water when you wash your hands with soap. In short, it prevents soap scum in your sink when you have hard water. Knowing this is the baseline to answer the pH question. You also have to know that soap is alkaline. It usually has a pH of around 9 to 10. Your skin is slightly acidic and has a pH of around 5.5. For comparison, distilled water is neutral and has a pH of 7. Citric acid is, like the name already says, an acid, whilst pure sodium hydroxide is a very strong base with a pH of 14. And perhaps you know that to neutralize base you need an acid and vice versa. So the conclusion is near that when you want to make a pH neutral skincare soap, you just add some citric acid to lower the pH. But no, it doesn't work that way. There are some other things to consider. First, the amount of citric acid used is very low compared to the amount of sodium hydroxide. You would need much more of it to neutralize all of your lye. Second, you don't get soap with neutralized lye. You still need free sodium hydroxide for saponification. That is why you only use a small amount of citric acid, or if you saw my citric acid video, add some extra sodium hydroxide to compensate the citric acid. Third, when you add citric acid to your lye solution, the citric acid will be consumed completely by the sodium hydroxide and sodium citrate is created. There's no free citric acid left. The final solution is not neutral or acidic, it is still alkaline. And the last point, because the citric acid is not an acid anymore, it can't lower the pH of your basic soap. It is not possible to pH balance your cold process soap with citric acid. Okay, that's a lot of stuff. Congratulations when you made it up here. Now the fun part begins. To make the whole thing tangible, we do a little experiment. This is how it is set up. I made three different soaps. The first one is without any additives, the second one is with citric acid, the third one is lye heavy. You should never use lye heavy soap, I made it just for a demonstration. There are some regulations on how to pH test soap the right way. I don't have a laboratory and all this fancy equipment you would need, but I tried to follow the instructions as far as I could. They are given in an ASTM international sheet. ASTM stands for American Society for Testing and Materials. The sheet ASTM D1172 is titled Standard Guide for pH of Aqueous Solutions of Soaps and Detergents. It says that the soap has to be diluted in distilled water for measuring the pH. Before diluting the soap in it, the distilled water shall be boiled to remove CO2. To determine the pH of the solution, it has to have a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius plus minus 2 degrees. I will test the pH with two different methods. I have a pH meter that I will use and I have some simple pH paper. I boiled the distilled water and prepared a 1% soap solution. That means 1 gram of the solution is soap and 99 grams are distilled water. I added the hot distilled water to the 1 gram piece of soap and stirred until the soap dissolved completely. Then I cooled it in a water bath because we need to measure the pH at about 40 degrees Celsius and the standard says the solution should be rapidly cooled. Okay, here we are. For comparison, on the right is pure distilled water at 25 degrees Celsius. The solution in the middle is soap with citric acid, the one on the left is without any additives. The soap bars I'm testing are 2 days old, so to say they are just out of the mold. First, I used the pH meter. The water has 6.71, which is expected neutral. I cleaned the pH meter in between the measurements of the two soap solutions with distilled water, but surprise, I measured for both soap solutions the same pH of 9.94. This is a very normal pH for soap. Now let's see what the pH paper says. I used a very simple one, you can get it everywhere for a fair price, and it has this color scheme printed on the box. It is definitely not as accurate as the pH meter, but it is good enough to see in what range your soap is. And this is also good enough when you want to know if your soap is LYE heavy. Looks like the water has a 6 to 7, and the soap solutions both look like they are 8 to 9. The pH I measured for the LYE heavy soap was 11.31. The pH paper turned into a very dark green. You can see the difference to the soap solutions which are not LYE heavy. They have a much lighter green on the paper. But you have to be careful when you use pH paper for testing LYE heavy soap. On this scale it doesn't look so dangerous, but there are some other hints that tell you that your soap is LYE heavy, but we will talk about this in another video. Just for fun, let's have a look at what pH a pure sodium hydroxide solution and a citric acid solution have. These are normal concentrations for soap making, meaning a 3% citric acid solution and a 33% sodium hydroxide solution. The sodium hydroxide is at 12.69 and the citric acid is at 1.49. Pretty normal for a base and an acid. The paper turns dark purple for the sodium hydroxide and red for the citric acid. When you test with the pH paper directly on your soap, you get a similar result. It turns dark green, indicating a pH of around 10. And now let's see what happens when you mix the sodium hydroxide with the citric acid. As the concentration of the citric acid is not very high, it does not have a big effect on the pH. I measured 12.54 with the pH meter and the paper is still purple. 5 days later, I did another measurement with the soap bars. I got a 10.63 for the one without additives and 10.55 for the one with citric acid. It is slightly higher than the week before, but still in a normal range for soap. And I did a third measurement after a curing time of 4 months. This time I got a 9.54 for the one without any additives and 9.47 for the one with citric acid. Conclusion. The normal pH range of cold process soap is between 9 and 10. If you use citric acid or not has no significant influence on the pH. You don't need to buy fancy laboratory stuff to measure the pH, some simple pH paper does the job. If you suspect your soap to be LYE heavy, it is good enough to verify that. And by the way, it is often said that citric acid also can prevent the so-called DOS, dreaded orange spots. These spots appear when the soap goes rancid. Citric acid is not able to prevent that. Just always use fresh oils and butters, never use them when they are too old and already smell strange, and use distilled water instead of tap water. This will prevent your soap from getting DOS. I hope you enjoyed the video and I could clarify some rumors for you. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and leave a comment if this video was helpful for you. Have a great day and see you next time. Bye!